All right, we've made it. My goodness, it's good evening, everyone, and welcome to the Insite Show. You're watching it here on madhousetv.com, and otherwise you wouldn't be watching it if you didn't know that already. But anyway, my foot pedal is gone right now, so I'll be looking down and up and down like this here for a while. But anyway, it's Thursday night. It's 8 p.m. or so after that, and it's August 14th, 2014. I'm your host, Reverend Dennis Gustaferri, or AKA Reverend Dennis. And I got to do this. Here we go. We have a great show planned for you this evening. We have joining us tonight a funny fellow, a comedian by the name of Alen Scott, who is here with me, and a very wonderful vocalist with us as well, Charlie Gange, who will be singing on our stage in a little while. So welcome aboard. So welcome, Alen. How are you doing?
Hi. Pleasure to be here.
My pleasure to have you. So, how long have you been doing comedy?
In my head, about 30 years, but actually on stage only about the past 6 to 9 months.
Oh, really? So, and you got hooked up with Mike, or did you go to his college or university?
No, I met Mike afterwards. I had actually gone to the Actors Connection and took a class with Sheila Smiley, a very, very funny lady, and took her 6-week workshop. And through her, got hooked up with Laughing Buddha Comedy with Jeff Lawrence in the city, and took a 6-week class with him. I'm one of these people that have to have all their ducks in a row before, you know, doing anything. And I just got hooked and got some great feedback, so just been pushing ahead ever since.
So, what style of comedy do you think, would you say you do? Is it more like a Don Rickles type of thing, or is it more like something different? Or
I guess it's more observational. Things happen in my life. I don't really sit down and do, like, okay, I want to do a bit about this and then write the joke around it. Something funny will come to me, or something will happen, or I'll say something funny in front of my kids and they'll laugh. I said, ooh, that's good, and I'll work on it, and I'll kind of expand it from there.
Well, I'm looking forward to hearing what you got tonight.
Yeah. So am I.
Well, I'd also like to introduce somebody who's alongside of you, sure. Who's been on this show a few times, and that's Charlie Gange, which is Gange. I always say that. I always
get three times on the show.
Yeah, maybe you'll find it next time.
Oh,
welcome, Charlie.
Good
how you doing?
How are you?
Good to see you. Welcome. Nice to meet you.
How you doing?
Good. So this is a very interesting show, and I like the idea of having you guys together like this. I normally would do it separately and all this, but I think it'd be nice to run in with the. With a couple of things, like where were some of the places you've played?
I played at the Broadway Comedy Club, the Stand, Eastville Comedy Club, Governors in Levittown a couple of weeks ago with Rain Pryor was the headliner on there. It was Richard Pryor's daughter, so that was an honor to be
wow,
able to perform with
nice.
Her. Yeah, yeah, she killed. She was so funny.
We gotta do something like that. We can have a whole big. Well, I've done that before. I had comedians on. I had can't think of his name. It's more or less.
You just said it.
Plays the banjo. Bayer. Bayer.
Okay.
That's Bayer.
Okay.
And I had his, actually, I did a show and I had him on the show with his group. He has a phenomenal bluegrass group. I don't know if you know that, but.
No.
Yeah, so every once in a while I try to throw a show like that and we try to get all the comedians down together. And I've had shows on here where I've had like 5 comedians and I throw out certain words and let them go up. It was really good, so I think we're going to do that again soon.
Yeah, the whole thing seems to be about networking. Like, I had met Kathy Arnold through just basically I saw her doing a show at the Stand, and so I got to know her. She invited me to do her show over at the Governor's Comedy Club. So everything's always been about networking.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
I'm looking forward to your stuff.
Now, Charlie, what have you been up to?
Very good. Doing well, thank you. And the last couple of times I've been on a show, I do Sinatra. And that's my thing. But I figured I'd bring something else different to the table today because I don't just do Sinatra. I do, you know, voice of Johnny Mathis and Dean Martin, Nat Cole, and Elton John. I'm a vocal, I guess you could say, impersonator is what I do. And Sinatra's my mainstream stuff, and I've always done that on this show. But tonight we're going to do a little bit different. I think Lil Martin, who's a tremendous.
Yeah.
Everybody. And, Dean Martin was a tremendous talent. So I'm going to do a little Dean Martin tonight, maybe a little Neil Diamond. See what else we got for you. All right,
something
a little bit different.
I hear you do an amazing Whitney Houston, too.
Is that? Okay, well, we could make that happen.
Okay. I look forward to seeing that.
So where you been, Charlie? What you been up to?
I'm just doing a lot of private stuff.
You're just still DJing.
Yeah, well, yeah, right? We have, exactly. Later on, we'll bring up my girlfriend who's behind here tonight with us. And yeah, we, you know, weddings and birthday parties, all types of stuff. We have different DJs to go with the crowd and the venue. And then I do a little bit of live entertainment, incorporate that. We do pictures, all kinds of stuff.
That was one of the things. I haven't seen you in a lot of years.
Yes.
Because we used to, I used to sing at your club.
Yes, right.
And then one day, years later, I go to an audition somewhere or something. I think I was playing there.
Right,
downstairs,
right.
I was doing a wedding. And you were upstairs, and you were with the DJ thing, and you're singing away, and I said, man, this is great.
Yeah, that's what we did now. You know, I used to do restaurants and stuff like that. And I decided that what you do in those parties is the way to go. And I always incorporate what I do live, but I bring a different DJ depending on what type of party it is. And then, we have pictures. We take pictures and stuff like that. It's good stuff.
So have you got something lined up in coming up or anything? Or?
No, I only do private stuff now. I wish I could say it would. Well, you know what?
Private.
This is a private. No. Well, actually,
it's
yes, that's 20, right.
Well, people
if anybody would like
him.
To know, go to Charles. Go to Charles, GANGE.com. Charles,
there you go.
GANGE.com. Look us up. If you're having any type of party and you would like to have entertainment along with the DJ.
And even have a comedian.
And a beautiful lady who could take some pictures for you. Millie's out there, my girlfriend. And absolutely.
Alan,
yeah, and a comedian.
Do you have a website or a contact number?
I'm on Twitter at directorguy.com, all one word, directorguy. And I'm on Facebook. I do not have a website. I haven't had a website in 20 years, but I just seem to travel by word of mouth.
All right. Well, it can get a little rough on the gums.
Yeah.
This is. I'm not a comedian. No, that's
all right.
I just throw it out there sometimes, see what happens.
I like that.
But this is. Now, Mike Dillon, how do you know Mike Dillon? Because he's the one that gave me you.
I went over to an open mic that one of my fellow comedians was at, and Mike just showed up. And so I was doing my set, and all of a sudden this new guy was over there, and he introduced himself and said, oh, you're Mike Dillon. I saw you on the comedy. Because on Facebook, we have different groups, different comedy groups.
Mm-hmm.
And he's probably on 6 or 8 of them. Wherever you go, there's Mike Dillon. You know. So he's asked me a few times. Exactly.
Yeah.
He asked me a couple of times to do his show, and he asked me to do the show tomorrow. And I said, well, I got my kids on vacation who are watching, by the way. Hi, Jared. Hi, Victoria.
Hi, kids.
Right, I have to see how
much. He asked me to do it. I said, oh, I'm on vacation. Then he asked me to do this. I said, yeah, sure, I'll do it. So he's probably saying like, oh, I see. You could do Madhouse TV, but you can't do my show on Friday. Thanks very much, you know? So
I have to ask you, who inspired you as far as your comics? You know, people that you...
I always loved Bill Cosby, Jerry Seinfeld, Ellen DeGeneres, and all those guys. Because one of the things they did is they didn't need to curse. Everything was very,
nice.
Very clean.
Right.
They got the biggest laugh. There was
is the funny part, Bill Cosby, with that shtick he did with the kids. My wife, he's great.
Oh, he's
Jerry's unbelievable.
Oh, I grew up with that as well.
Right.
I love his stand-up. I think he's, and he does similar to what you were saying. He takes situations pretty much of...
Everyday situations.
Everyday situations.
Sure.
Yeah, so great stuff.
We can relate
to
it.
Seinfeld, great talk to you.
This is great. No, this is what I was hoping for that was going to happen. You guys were going to hit it off and...
We don't need to. No. I'll do some interviewing. No.
I can still do that.
Yeah.
Well, I tell you what. I'm going to turn it over to myself for a minute. I'm going to do a little opening monologue that I usually do. And because of my foot pedal, I have a... This is awesome. No one ever sees it because it's right by the camera. It's a teleprompter because I don't have a memory.
Okay.
I have no mind whatsoever. It's gone.
You're doing pretty good.
Well, right now it's on. But now I'm going to get into something here. So I've got to resort to going to this. So here we go. I thought that I would remind everyone about our Insite Show theme, which is from the old George Burns movie called Oh God, which is Think God. But I've got to do this and up and down here because of that. But I've said this before, and it's worth repeating again. When I was ordained, I was told to go forth and spread the word of our Lord God. And I thought to myself then, everyone knows God. Now I see through a mirror lit dimly. God is not on everybody's lips. Right now, it seems that people are turning away from God. I just heard on the news just yesterday that Bibles are being removed from our servicemen and servicewomen armed forces. how can they be doing this? It's a small group of atheists who can go into a court and petition the court to remove Bibles by saying it's unconstitutional or their rights are being violated. And the court entertains it. How can this be? How can we stand by and let this happen? No one is forcing anyone to read the Bible or any other book for that matter. But why the Bible? You can say it's science fiction if you like, if you choose to believe or not. Yes, religion is a free choice. You're not forced to be in a religion, except at birth. Your family may decide for you, but you still have to confirm when you get older. So it's just something that the country was formed under it, under the term, under God. So why take it away from those who want it? Why is it forced on you? Maybe these problems that are so prevalent now would not be if we followed the truth teaching of all religion. Not the crazy factions that are using the Bible, Torah, Quran, or any other religious book in the name of religion to destroy human life. Yes, all of these books show terrible things being done to people back in the beginning. But these books also talk of peace, love, and family, home and respect, hope, faith, and doing good things. Ask a Hindu why he wears a band around their wrist. They'll tell you that the answer is that it's to remind them to do good things with their hands. Spreading the word of God isn't so easy after all. As far as what is going on in Gaza and with ISIS and dealing with evil, maybe reading Ecclesiastes 3, a time for everything may give you the answer. There's a time for everything and a season for every activity under the heavens. 2, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to uproot. 3, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to tear down and a time to build. 4, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance. 5, a time to scatter stones and time to gather them, a time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing. 6, a time to search and a time to give up, a time to keep and a time to throw away. 7, a time to tear and a time to mend, a time to be silent and a time to speak. 8, a time to love and a time to hate, a time for war and a time for peace. As for spreading your word, from Psalms 89, I will sing of the Lord's great love forever. With my mouth, I will make your faithfulness known throughout all generations. Anyway, thank you for listening. And I'll go right back to my friends here. If I can stop that.
Well said. Very nice to meet
you. Thank you. I had to read it because, like I said, my mind is gone.
I think you did great. Perfect.
Yeah. But we're gonna take a commercial break right now. And when we come back, I'm going to be doing some songs over there. And then we're going to have you guys up. And it's going to be a great show and a great time. Thank you so much for sticking around. Ladies and gentlemen, don't go away. We'll be right back after these words.
I'm Natalie Boyle, and you're watching MadhouseTV.com.
YesWeCare.net is a 501c3 charity that provides help to veterans and their families. Please visit YesWeCare.net and donate in any way you can by purchasing our beautiful frame prints or relaxation CDs and DVDs, even smooth jazz CDs. YesWeCare.net. Remember, our troops are on their way home. They need all the support they can get. YesWeCare.net.
Hi, I'm Jerry Parisi, and you're watching MadhouseTV.com.
Hey, You're watching the Maverick Soul Hour with Tommy Maher right here on MadhouseTV.com. That's right. You're watching...
My name is Dr. Robert Brevard. I'm here for Multimedicine in Westbury, New York. We're located at 1065 Old Country Road, Suite 214. Been here for about 15 years. The practice has medical doctors, physical therapists, chiropractors, acupuncturists. We also do pain management, and we have orthopedists on staff. Here at Advanced Multimedicine Rehabilitation, we've got physical therapists on staff who treat an array of conditions, from neck pain to back pain, shoulder pain. We treat carpal tunnel. We treat a lot of car accident patients, slip and falls. We treat patients with knee injuries, with ankle injuries. We have state-of-the-art equipment. We've been here for over 15 years. Vast array of diagnostic testing, from x-rays to EMGs. What is an EMG? It's a diagnostic test that allows a doctor to determine where the pinched nerve is. Cora is a physical therapist at Advanced Multimedicine and Rehabilitation. She's working on Stephanie, who was involved recently in an automobile accident. Stephanie has tight thoracic and cervical musculature, and Cora is doing some myofascial release work and some therapeutic stretching, doing it to help her with her pain. Vicky is also a patient here at Advanced Multimedicine and Rehabilitation. Vicky is now working her leg muscles, specifically her quadricep muscles, trying to strengthen them after an injury she sustained. Find yourself in need of any type of physical therapy, please don't hesitate to call Advanced Multimedicine and Rehabilitation, located in Westbury, New York, in Suite 214. Phone number is 516-334-7000, or find us on our website at advancedmultimedicine.com.
All right, we are back. I think we're back. Yes, we're back. Anyway, thank you for sticking around. You're watching the Insite Show, and you're going to be seeing some comedy, and you're going to hear some vocals, and that's where I get my chance right now, too. So I'm about to do a song for you that I really cared for. You know, I sang a lot of doo-wop back in the day. I was with the Bob Knight Four for 8 years and all that good stuff, but... There was a song called Up on the Roof that was done then, but I like this version so much better, and it's the version by James Taylor. So with that, let me cue up my band, put the cigarettes out, guys, let's go.
When this old world starts getting me down, and people are just too much for me to face, I climb way up to the top of the stairs, and all my cares just drift right into space. On the roof, it's peaceful as can be. And then the world below don't bother me, no, no. So when I come home feeling tired and beat, I'll go up where the air is fresh and sweet now. I get far away from the hustle and crowd, and all that rat race noise down in the street. On the roof, it's peaceful as can be. And darling, you can share it all with me. Was if I remember the words, it'd be nice too. At night the stars, they put on a show for free. And darling, you can't share it all with me. That's what I said, I keep a telling you, right smack dab in the middle of town, I found a paradise that's trouble-proof. And if this old world starts a-getting you down, there's room enough for two up on the roof. Up on the roof. Yeah, up on. Everything is all right, everything is all right, yeah. You got the stars above, the city lights below. You just gotta go, take a little stroll, go up on the road. The long song at the end, but we'll stay around, kicking it out one more time. Up on the roof, yeah. City lights, stars above, falling up. Up on the roof, yeah.
Why, thank you so much. Maybe next time if I do it, I'll remember the words and get through the whole song the right way. But this next song is another James Taylor song, but this one I should have without a problem. I won't sing it for 100 years, so. Of course, you never know. What's his name?
Do me wrong, do me right now, baby. Come on, tell me lies, but hold me tight. Save your goodbyes for the morning light. But don't let me be lonely tonight. Say goodbye, say hello. Sure enough, good to see you, but it's time to go. Don't say yes, but please don't say no. I don't want to be lonely tonight. Go ahead and damn you. Go on and do as you please, yeah. You ain't gonna see me getting down on my knees. I'm undecided and your heart's been you've been turning my world upside down now. Do me wrong, do me right now, baby. Come on, tell me lies, but hold me tight. Save your goodbyes for the morning light. Don't let me be lonely tonight. I don't want to be lonely tonight. No, no, let me be lonely tonight. Thank you. All right. Thank you very much, folks. Don't you go away. We're going to be right back in a few seconds with Alen Scott. So don't you go away.
Technical Worldwide Tattoo Supply is one of the largest suppliers in the world and your number one resource for top quality, affordable tattoo and piercing supplies. Technical Worldwide Tattoo Supply is the number one supplier of tattoo inks in the world with more than 200 products including Mom's Ink, Philadelphia Eddie's Traditional Inks, Paolini Sacred Color Inks, and more. Technical Worldwide Tattoo Supply, your one-stop shopping destination for great service, best prices, and top quality supplies. Coney Island Carlos vintage wines and premium spirits are undeniably distinctive, selected for their unique, memorable flavor. Coney Island Carlos vintage wines and premium spirits are delivered to you in beautifully designed bottles featuring limited edition artwork. Coney Island Carlos vintage wines and premium spirits are available at affordable prices in fine restaurants, bars, and liquor stores. Or check www.coneyislandcarlo.com for availability.
Hi, I'm Natalie Boyle, and you're watching MadhouseTV.com.
Hi, my name is Dr. Tom Dow. We have a multidiscipline practice in Melville and Ronkonkoma, New York, and we treat patients with many, many different conditions, from newborns through geriatric patients with numerous different techniques. There's a technique and a type of treatment for every class of patient. We have them all here. Here's my son Thomas, also a doctor of chiropractic, working on one of our patients' cervical spine. This patient has had chronic neck pain for many, many, many years, has been to a multitude of different practitioners with little or no response. And with our specialized techniques, she has improved tremendously and continues to improve on a daily basis. We have two practices, one in Melville and one in Ronkonkoma, New York. We are a multidiscipline chiropractic office. What that means is we have chiropractors, massage therapists, acupuncturists, psychologists, all working as a team and a network of outside professionals such as orthopedists and neurologists that we work hand in hand with to help determine what your injuries are and the best way to treat your injuries. I have the great pleasure of having my son in practice with me. We work hand in hand, father and son, to give our patients the best care possible and a staff which is loving, caring, and you'll never have to wait at all in our office for service. Many times patients come into our office and they have what's called a soft tissue injury. Soft tissue injuries are like scars inside your body. If you've ever been cut on the outside of your body, you get a scar. The same thing happens inside of your body to your muscles and ligaments. So our job is to determine where those are, stretch the muscles, adjust the vertebra back into their correct position, and then refortify the normal structure with exercise.
That's what we
do best, and I hope someday you'll come see us at one of our two offices. Thank you.
All right, we're back, ladies and gentlemen. As promised, we are going to the comedy section, even though you think that was me, it's not. So here we go with Alen Scott. Take it away, Alen.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Dennis. It's great to be here. It's great to be back in New York. I do have to get something off my chest first and foremost. I was mugged this afternoon, unfortunately. Everyone's okay. No one was hurt. It could have been a lot worse, but they took $250. Well, they didn't actually take it right then and there. The officer said I had to mail it in. I don't mind getting pulled over. I really don't. But, you know, I just don't like that they pretend it's about this public safety issue. You know, why not just tell me the real reason why you're pulling me over? Just once I want a cop to be honest with me. Pull me over and say, like, boy, I clocked you doing 90 miles an hour. I had to do 110 just to catch up to you. Boy, that was awesome. Let's do it again. You know, really, I mean, I want the officer to even continue and tell me the exact reason. Something like, you know, I personally want to thank you for your generous donation of $250. Now we can afford the stripper for our Christmas in August party, which will be on September 7th, all right? And that will be up there on the Church of Atheism. So just here's your ticket. You need to show that at the door, and you can get your non-alcoholic drink. All right. So listen, thank you. I just wanted to get that off my chest. So anybody here ever have biological parents? A couple of you? All right. I see one in the back. That's great. I had two myself. I think I might have been a disappointment to my mother. I'm not sure. I think she might have wanted a girl. I'm just saying. Because when I was 6 years old for Halloween, she dressed me up as a princess and sent me out. Seriously. Now, in all fairness, she did say it was my idea. But I was six. Who listens to a six-year-old? Hey, Ma, can I play with matches? No. Ma, can I juggle chainsaws? No. Hey, Ma, can I dress up as a princess on Halloween? Ooh, let me help you make your costume. Oh, you need a tiara? Oh, and a wand, a magic wand. So out I go as Disney's newest fairy princess, Hermaphrodite. Didn't get much worse. Better after that, actually. A couple of years later, I went out as a witch, complete with the pointy hat and broomstick. All right. A couple of years later, cheerleader, complete with pom-poms and water balloons. And I wonder what my dad was thinking through all this. I said, Dad, why didn't you say something? Why didn't you try to stop it? He's like, well, you know, your mom, when she puts her, I got nothing. So it was no surprise to anyone when I came out of the closet as a lesbian. So, let's see, lesbian childhood, blah, 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 got married, love of my life, blah, blah, blah. Now I'm divorced. Anyone else here divorced? A couple of people? All right, that's welcome to the club. So before my wife left, she suggested that I seek therapy. Now, she's always been right about everything. If you don't believe me, just ask her. So I looked into it. There's hypnotherapy. There's psychotherapy. I went with massage therapy. Very relaxing. I go to this new place now. It's called Happy Beginnings. It's amazing. I mean, they can relax the hardest spot in like 4 minutes. It's amazing. So the therapy must be working now because I'm now in a monogamous relationship with two women. I met them both online. It was great. You know, anybody else doing the online dating? Anybody? Is this people still do that? A couple of people? All right. What do you got? You got the Match.com, eHarmony.com. Oh, yes, BrokebackMountain.com. I recognize your face. Yes? Very nice to see you. Good to see you. Thank you. Thanks for coming. Great sites, you know, except, you know, on one of them, they always had these women who would post like one photo of themselves and then like six photos of their pets. I mean, what am I supposed to message these women? Like, hey, I don't think we're compatible, but I'd really love to play with your Shih Tzu. You know, it's tough. It's tough out there being single, especially after divorce. So, what else? You know, I just joined this new site now. What is it? Facebook. That's what it is. Yes, Facebook. Great. It's very confusing, though. You know, because they only have three options whenever someone posts something. You have a like, comment, and share. And that's it. I was reading about a friend of mine who had passed away recently, and he had 66 likes. You like that he died?
I know.
Isn't that kind of cold? I mean, how would that be in the real world? Hey, did you hear that Frank passed away? Oh, really? I like that. I am so going to share that. And then they go on and they'll post comments to the dead person on their site, like they're supposed to be able to read them or something. I'm like, well, you know, I want to type in there. You know, they don't have internet in heaven. Maybe in hell they do. What would they have in hell? They would have Firefox, Hotmail, or even worse, AOL. But you know what I want to do is I want to hire someone so that after I die, they can post things on my site. All right? So when someone posts something up there like, well, it looks like heaven needed a new comedian, they can post something back with, like, having one hell of a time. See you soon. Thank you all very much. You've been fantastic. Thank you. Thank you.
Alan Scott, thank you so much.
Thank you for having me.
Great time, and stick around. We've got more stuff coming up.
Love
Ladies
to.
And gentlemen, don't go away. We'll be right back, and we have, what do we have? Charlie Gange's coming up to do some vocals. That's who we have. Yeah. We'll be right back after the short message.
Oh, you're going on first.
No, I'm just going to say
hello. You're going to say hello.
Yeah. Right. Hey, you see, we're having a good conversation.
Hey, you like that, hey?
Hey, what's going on?
Hey, it's a show.
Hey, listen, we're going to be right there. No, we're here.
Okay.
Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands at home together while we do it here for Charlie Gange.
Thank you. Something by one of my favorite Italian-Americans, other than Sinatra, of course, Mr. Great Dean Martin.
Something in your kiss just told me my someplace is now.
Everybody finds somebody someplace.
There's no telling where love may be. Something in your kiss, oh, just told me my someplace is here. If I had it in my power, I'd arrange for every girl to have your charms. Then every minute, every hour, every boy would find what I found in your arms. Sometimes, and although my dreams was over you, your kiss meant it all worth waiting for someone like you.
If I had my power,
how I'd arrange for every girl to have your charm. Every boy would find what I found in your arms. Oh, everybody loves somebody sometime. And although my dreams was over you, your kiss made it all worth waiting for someone.
Everybody loves somebody.
Ladies and gentlemen, how are you all doing? Folks, I just have to take one moment to say, once again, don't forget, charlesgange.com is the website, and we do all different types of parties, different DJs for different venues, and like I said before, we take pictures. We do take pictures, and tonight, in the audience, I happen to have behind every good man is a great woman. So I'd like to introduce my girlfriend. Come on up, please. That's right, we do take pictures. And Millie helps me with my business a lot, so. Hi, babe. She helps me with my business tremendously. And contracts and emails, because I don't type too well. And terrible handwriting, so she writes them out. But we take pictures, and Millie does all the photos. And she does. You enjoy doing the photos, right?
Yes, very much so.
Do you enjoy working with me?
Most of the time.
Come on. Now, she does all the photos. She does a tremendous job. She takes all the photos. And the great thing about that, I know we don't have much time, is that if you're doing a wedding, it takes 4 or 5 months to get those photos back. But we give you the photos right then and there, right after the affair. And she's right on top of it. She doesn't stop. We get all the photos. But I just want to say thank you. And thank you for helping me in my career. Okay? I'm going to sing a song now.
You're welcome.
Give me a kiss. See you later. All right, we're back, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, Millie. How about a nice round of applause for Millie, who just came up? We just wait for music. Hey, I got a microphone. It's coming. I think the band was on the break. You know what I need? I think I need a little drink, that's all. On with no alcohol, you know what I'm saying? Return to me. Oh, my dear, I'm so lonely. Hurry home, hurry back. Won't you please hurry back? I'm yours. Return to me. For my heart wants you only. Hurry home, hurry back. To my lips, to my arms, to my heart. My darling, if I hurt you, I'm so sorry. Forgive me. And please say you are mine. Return to me. Please come back, Bellamy. Her back, her home, to my lips, to my arms, to my heart. A little Italian right now. The only Italian I know what to show. Return. Caro mio, ti amo. Sola tu. Thank you.
favorite Dee Martin songs. Thank you. Thank you. You like that Italian?
I kind of don't even know what we're doing next, but or maybe something by the great Neil Diamond. I think, right, Tommy?
This is something by the great Neil Diamond. Any Neil Diamond fans out there? Great song. I might need a little microphone in here. I know it's out there good, but for this one. Thanks, Tom. There you go. Hello again, hello. Just called to let you know I couldn't sleep at all tonight, and I know it's late, but I couldn't wait. Hello, my friends, hello. Just called to let you know I think about you every night when I'm here alone and you're there at home. Hello. Yeah, it's been crazy. Maybe I'm to blame, but I put my heart above my head. We've been through it all. You love me just same. When you're not there, I just need to hear hello again, hello. It's good to meet you so. It's good to hear you say that you feel this way. Hello. I'll play it pretty for the folks now. Hello, my friends, hello. Just called to let you know I think about you every night when I'm here alone and you're there at home. Hello, hello, hello. Somebody great Neil Diamond, thank you. Thank you. Love that song, thank you. I have no idea what we're doing next. Yeah, but I don't know what it is. So I'll be just surprised at you. Johnny Mathis, any Johnny Mathis fans out there? You ask how much I love you. Must I explain? I need you, oh my darling. Like roses need rain. You ask how long I love you, I'll tell
unto the 12th of heaven, I'll still be loving you. Oh, and melt my heart like ever snow. Hello, you to the heavens. Forget to bloom. To the 12th of heaven, and that's a real long time. Until the 12th of heaven, and that's a real long time.
Pretty song by the great Johnny Mathis. Hope you enjoy it. Thank you. Thank you, folks. Thank you. A little different in Sinatra, huh?
All right. Very like nice stuff. Very nice stuff.
A little different in Sinatra. Right. Thank you so much. Thank
yes.
You.
Well, don't go away.
Oh, I'm not going anywhere.
We're going to be right back after this real quick commercial. And
is
we'll
it a
have
quick one?
It's well. And then we'll have you back there and everybody back there and all that stuff back there. Don't go away. We'll be right back.
You got it. Thank you.
Technical Worldwide Tattoo Supply is one of the largest suppliers in the world and your number one resource for top quality, affordable tattoo and piercing supplies. Technical Worldwide Tattoo Supply is the number one supplier of tattoo inks in the world with more than 200 products including Mom's Ink, Philadelphia Eddie's Traditional Inks, Paolini Sacred Color Inks, and more. Technical Worldwide Tattoo Supply, your one-stop shopping destination for great service, best prices, and top quality supplies. Coney Island Carlos vintage wines and premium spirits are undeniably distinctive, selected for their unique, memorable flavor. Coney Island Carlos vintage wines and premium spirits are delivered to you in beautifully designed bottles featuring limited edition artwork. Coney Island Carlos vintage wines and premium spirits are available at affordable prices in fine restaurants, bars, and liquor stores. Or check www.coneyislandcarlo.com for availability.
Hi, I'm Natalie Boyle, and you're watching MadhouseTV.com.
Ladies and gentlemen, I want to thank you so much for sticking around with us tonight on MadhouseTV.com and on my show, The Insite Show. I'd like to thank comedian, our agent, Mike Dillon, He's at the Gateway of Comedy. He's the one who's the agent who's supplying us with our comedians. I'd like to thank him for this. So if you want to go to Gateway, gatewaytocomedy.com, and you can also call Mike at 631-790-4046 for more information. So thank you again. I'd also like to thank Great Scott. I'd like to thank Alan Scott for coming and doing the show tonight. And big props. That was really good. And we also have my favorite there, which is my favorite crooner, all right, Charlie Gange. They're doing more than his usual blue eyes. So that was good. That was really good stuff. So meanwhile, thank you so much again. I want to thank our crew, Tom and Vicky Mealy, and the Madhouse crew, Madhouse TV crew. And even though Tom's not here and Janine Zarelli's not here, and Tommy Marr's not here right now, they're away on doing something, you're missed. All right? So, but thank you all. You're all terrific. Now I get to do my little song. This way I get to honor God and country. Expect you all to be singing at home with me. God bless America, land that I love. Stand beside her and guide her through the night with the light from above, from the mountains to the prairies, to the oceans, why would God bless America, my home, sweet home. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give our props to our first responders, to our police departments and our fire departments, and to our soldiers who are out there defending our freedom, and to the veterans who've been there and done that. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you the greatest country in the world. Sing it out with me, come on. God bless America, my home sweet home. Everybody, God bless. See you next week.